Welcome to Meet the Experts with Mike Vilardi. Join us each week as we bring you expert opinions on different subjects ranging from medical to political and community to economy. We answer all of your questions live. Have a question? Call into the show at 888-994-4995, Studio A. And now to Mike.
Welcome to Meet the Experts. I'm your host, Mike Vilardi. We're going to have an amazing new show for you tonight. And first, I'm going to give you, clarify my areas of expertise. Number one is tax resolution. I was an IRS special agent for 22 years, a criminal investigator, and I spent the last 12 years helping people who have tax problems. That's one of my two areas of expertise. The other one is on Bible prophecy. This is one of my three books that I wrote, and we'll be getting into that later on. But tonight, I have a special guest with me. I have Denise Painter, who's a political consultant and a pollster. Welcome to Meet the Expert, Denise. It's a pleasure to have you on our show.
Thank you so much, Mike. It's nice to be here.
Denise, tell us about your areas of expertise. I know you've been in politics a long, long time, and that's why you're on the show, because you've done many, many things, and I want our audience to know about you and what you've accomplished.
Well, thank you so much. I first got involved in politics right after college when I worked for the main political consultant of the Republican Party, which is Lee Atwater.
Oh, Lee Atwater, absolutely.
Yes, okay. Lee Atwater. And Lee Atwater, of course, was chairman of the RNC, and I learned a lot from him. So I've always been involved in politics, and first got involved in politics doing consulting and campaign managing under Lee Atwater, and then I went on to work in the Reagan administration at DOD, Congressional Affairs, and also I went on to work at VA, Congressional Affairs. I was director of Congressional Affairs, served on Capitol Hill Science Committee, and then went back to consulting and polling.
So you've been that's tremendous. I mean, that's a long time ago. But that's a lot of experience.
I was 12.
That's a lot of experience. And so you've been on the Republican side of the aisle the whole time.
Yes, I have. Although I have worked a couple of campaigns that for candidates who are nonpartisan races. And I'm so happy that I was able to work for some of those campaigns that were Democrats, because I learned a lot. I learned how the other side works, mm-hmm. and they operate very differently than the Republican side. And that has helped a lot with grassroots campaigning for smaller races in particular.
So you've basically been involved in politics, I would say, you have 40 years of experience.
I would say so.
Is that about right?
Yes.
That's tremendous. And tell us some of your war stories. Tell us some of your interesting things that have happened throughout the years. And then I'm going to ask you to comment on our current political climate, because I want your expertise on this.
Okay. Well, I'd like to tell you a little story just about consulting. Consultants have been around for a very long time. And, you know, over the years, many candidates have had their kitchen cabinet, and people that they know and that they trust around them. And but probably President McKinley, right around the 1897 to 1901, he had the first political consultant, which I think a lot of people would be surprised that the business has been around that long. And then in the 1930s to the 1950s, there was a political consulting firm called Campaigns Incorporated that ran political campaigns out of California. And then, of course, once we had television in the 60s, that's when it really got ramped up. And so the 60s, late 60s and early 70s, just a little bit of history about that. And polling came along even earlier. 1824, the first polling took place when they sent out telegrams and asked people how they were going to vote. So we've come a long way since then, and a lot of things have changed. And in the last 5 years, things have even changed with the changes in technology and everything. So I would say that my biggest and most interesting stories, of course, were when I worked with Lee Atwater. Mm-hmm. He was the most exciting, dynamic person mm-hmm. I have ever met. He could have a room full of people and excite them about politics and news of the day. He'd call everyone in and say, the news is on, we've got to watch it. And I am very grateful that I was able to learn and work with Lee Atwater.
Now, Lee Atwater, he passed away a while ago.
He did. He had a brain tumor. Yeah. And unfortunately passed away from the brain tumor. Yes.
Because he was the up-and-coming next presidential candidate before he got sick.
I would say that George Bush would have been mm-hmm. reelected if Lee Atwater had been on board. He had been around. So very influential. And like I said, I learned a lot from him in regard to consulting and in regard to polling.
I mean, that George Bush election was kind of strange because you had a third party, right? Perot came into that race. And it was the only political race, if I remember correctly, where Bill Clinton, who won it, won with a minority instead of a majority.
Okay.
He did not have 50% of the vote, because Perot pulled off like 19%.
Yeah.
And that was a
very... Ross Perot hated George Bush, hated him. He was willing to hurt the country to destroy George Bush. So that race was very, very interesting. At that time, of course, I was involved in the policy side, which is what I think, I bring to candidates when I work with them, is my strong sense of policy that I've had many years of experience with.
Wow. Now, how many candidates have you worked with?
Oh, gosh. I don't know. I haven't kept track. But anywhere from school board up to presidential races, I've worked and been a team member of. Congressional races, school board races, Senate races, commissioners. Wow. Yeah, you name it. I've done it.
So, I have to ask you this question.
Okay.
The current politics of the day, what are your thoughts, and where do you think 2024 is going to take us?
The first part is easy. The last part of that question is not so easy. I have worked with both sides. When I worked on Capitol Hill for the Science Committee, we worked together. We would put things into a bill and we'd say, well, we know we're going to sit down, we're going to have to give that up. We worked together. I have never seen anything like what we are experiencing now. And unfortunately, we have in the Oval Office a person who is mentally incapacitated with dementia. And I see such division between Democrats and Republicans, and such hatred on both sides, and you cannot really get anything accomplished with such extremism. I think that I have always thought that it was important to have a balance. Mm-hmm. You know, you have to have, if you have an extremist on the right, then you need an extremist on the left to mm-hmm. balance that out. But what we have now is a total division, and no one's working with one another, and it actually frightens me. And where we're going to go in 2024?
Well, let
me
stop
you
right there, because I just want to make a comment on that. When I ran for Congress, I remember going up to people saying, hi, I'm Mike Vilardi, I'm running for Congress. And they'd say, oh, you're a Democrat or Republican? I said, I'm a Republican. They go, you're a Republican? I could never vote for a Republican. And I'd go, you haven't even heard my issues. And I'd go down them. And of course, they'd agree with everything, because all my issues were like making Social Security tax-free for the elderly, giving you a tax deduction when they take the tax because you're double taxed otherwise, having a separate trust fund. So they couldn't say no to my issues.
Right.
But instead of saying, well, some people would say, okay, I'll vote for you. Other people, most would say, well, if you were a Democrat, I'd vote for you.
It's party politics.
Yes.
And that, unfortunately, is bad for the American people.
Yes.
And it concerns me greatly.
Yep.
But I will continue to work for the Republicans to get them elected because I believe that they are on the right side in defense of the American people.
It seems like, I mean, my parents were Democrats. I was a Democrat for a short period of time. But at that time, it was people like JFK who said, ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country.
Mm-hmm.
And he cut taxes.
He was actually a great, great president.
Yeah.
And when you really look and study what he stood for and what he said, I mean, he was ready to bring down the CIA.
Yes, that's why they took him out.
That's why they took him out. If he were here today, he would be dismantling DOJ and the FBI and
the IRS. That's another thing. Yeah, well, you know. Well, you know, the IRS certainly took a beating over the Lois Lerner issue.
Yes. They should have.
As they should have, and that's why they were defunded. But now, I don't know if you've heard the news about the IRS. You know, of course, Joe Biden said nobody over 400,000, no additional taxes, right? So they came out with a program. They're going after waiters and waitresses.
It's horrible.
Okay?
Right.
These people who barely get by on their tips.
Right.
But the IRS is going to make sure that they pay every penny of tax on those tips that they earn.
Right. Right. Oh, no. This administration is going after the American middle class because a democracy cannot survive without a strong middle class.
Right. Well, they're going to make everybody poor.
Right.
Because who votes Democrat? The poor.
Right.
And
but they do have a great get-out-the-vote plan.
The
Democrats know how to get people to the polls.
You know, and even this congressional race with Dan Francis, he got 2 out of every 3 votes on Election Day.
Yes.
But he lost mail-in ballots by 50,000 mail-in ballots.
Right. But I think we're going to see that change here in Florida with the change in the law. So all of those ballots that were mailed out automatically, 500,000 ballots were mailed out in Palm Beach County. And that will not happen starting this year because people will have to re-request their ballot. Whereas in the past, you requested a ballot, it was good for 2 years. So that will be a very important change.
All right. Well, Denise, I want to just tell you we're out of time, and it was a tremendous opportunity having you on the show.
Thank you.
Thank you for being on Meet the Experts. It was a pleasure. Always
Thank
a pleasure
you.
Seeing
Thank
you and having
you, so
you on the
much.
Show. And we're going to go to a commercial break, and we'll be back with 2 new guests in several minutes. Thank you very much for watching and tuning in tonight.
Text alert! Text alert!
I was receiving letter after letter from the IRS.
I got Mike Vilardi on the phone, and I said, Mike, I got a problem.
He took the pressure off my shoulders.
He just made me feel like I had Superman on my side.
Trust me, he's the man to go to.
IRS problems? I'm Mike Vilardi, enrolled agent. I can help. My company, Winning Tax Solutions, has always gotten our clients the best possible results. Visit us at winningtaxsolutions.com or call us today.
You've been watching Meet the Experts with Mike Vilardi. If you have any questions, call in at 888-994-4995, Studio A. And now, back to the show.
Welcome back to the show. All right, now we got 2 tremendous guests that are they're on the other side of the studio right now. Rob Werner, thank you for coming on the show. Welcome.
And
you're welcome. We're going to be talking about the ERC credits. And we have bankruptcy attorney Adam Farber, who is here with us. And this is a new program that that's part of the COVID relief program. And these tax credits have been giving back to the people. And Rob is an expert on this particular program. And that's why he's on the show, Meet the Experts, tonight. Rob, why don't you tell us about the program?
Well, thanks for having me, Michael. Essentially, these tax credits were came out around when PPP came out, which was commonly known payment protection plan for COVID, for businesses that struggled through the 2021 era.
Okay.
ERC has been out since then. It's just untapped. It is not a loan. This is money that people paid into their tax payrolls.
Right. So let me just clarify. It is, if you're an employer, you have more than five employees, and you paid your 940 and 941 taxes, which are the withholding taxes for Social Security, Medicare, and federal income taxes, then the government is going to give you this money back.
That's correct. Up to $26,000
per employee. Right.
So five or more employees, you need to go, you know, you should take a look at our website. It's www.my123erc.com. And you'll get a lot of the information there. And for those who want to apply, it's 5 seconds. You put your name, tell us how many employees you have, and one of our agents will get back to you.
Give us that information again.
That's www.my123erc.com.
ERC.com.
Right.
And if you want to reach us by phone, you can reach me at my law office, 561-299-1413. I'm working with Robbie and the Crooken Law Trust, helping with these ERCs. And I did want to mention one other thing. There's a lot of companies that are popping up starting to do this.
Yes, there
and
are.
I just want to give fair warning to folks out there that when it came to those PPP loans, there were some people who did it wrong, didn't use law offices, didn't do it right. And some people are facing fraud charges and clawbacks. Some people even did jail time. Robbie was telling me he knows somebody who did an interview with somebody who I think got 48 months, right?
I believe it was 48 months. It was RDAP Dan. You can look him up. It was 5 months ago. He interviewed somebody. They took $400,000. They paid every penny of it back, and he was still sentenced. Right. And this was done through a broker, as a matter of fact.
So the key is do it right. Do it with some lawyers. Do it with the Crooken Law Trust. And don't just pick some random company out there. Do it with professionals.
Yeah, because the criminal division of the IRS is going back after this, and there is Robbie, just for 2 minutes before I read some of these articles of other people they arrested, tell us about Warburg Capital and how we are guaranteeing the money when they go through the Crooken Law Trust.
Good. Okay, so Warburg Equities is an affiliate of ours.
Yes.
And it was one of the main reasons we made this decision to work in this space. Number one, we don't charge egregious fees up to 30% on a recapture fee. It's usurious, in my opinion. You've already paid into it. This money is yours. We're not looking to, take 30%. So we're always at a flat fee. And using and having Warburg as an associate, Mike, has taken that, has just made us feel so much better about getting into this space.
Right.
And it's about getting the clients paid sooner rather than later because they're...
Right. So you're at 20, depending on, on the bigger corporations, mid-size, we're actually able to get you funding in advance because this is offered or given to you by the Treasury Department. So there could be a wait. So we're able to actually get you some money up front while you wait. Capital infusion for small businesses or all businesses alike is huge, especially in today's economic hardships.
No, it is. And I think what they're also doing, Warburg, correct me if I'm wrong, is they have an insurance company that's going to guarantee once the claim is filed and it goes through the Crooken Law Trust, and everything's done correctly and their people check it out, it's insured. So if something happened with the government, there's an insurance company that's going to guarantee that you're going to get that money. Is that right?
And that's right. It's on a per transaction basis. It's really for the bigger companies, Mike, but there is an insurance put into place, and we're talking big insurance companies, not smaller rent stuff.
Right. So just as you mentioned, some of the other companies that are out there, this was an article that just came out in a recent investigation. I'm just going to read it real quick. Two Utah County men business charged with $11 million COVID tax fraud scheme. Salt Lake City, Utah. Two Utah County men, as well as an accounting business in Provo, have been charged with a COVID-related tax fraud scheme totaling more than $11 million. And the reason I say this is if you get involved with the wrong people, with the wrong company, one, you're going to get robbed. You're going to end up, you could possibly end up like these people. They're going to go to jail for a long time because they didn't do it right. They stole the money. They were fraudulent in taking advantage of these programs. And you see that too often or not. When I was a criminal investigator for 22 years with the IRS, people get greedy. And when you have programs like this and there's a greed factor involved, they come in with false claims and they try to take that money. They think you're giving it away anyway. We're going to come in and get it. And this is what happened. They get arrested. And all the people, the legitimate people that might get involved with them, all of a sudden they're getting looked at. And Warburg, right, and as well as the Crooked Law Trust, of course, we make sure that doesn't happen.
I want to speak to that. The synergy at the Crooked Law Trust and Warburg, the people that are actually putting a set of eyes on us, mm-hmm. a 22-year retired special investigator,
right.
Mike Vilardi.
Right.
Wade Cricken, myself, a retired white-collar crime investigator. In fact, I had a case here in 2017 in Broward, and that gentleman wound up doing 15 years hard time. So we don't play around. We don't reach out to people. As a marketing company, we take this very serious. And we put a set of eyes on it. We give it to Warburg. Warburg puts a set of eyes on it. And we get you your money as fast as we possibly can.
And I think the key is we're not trying to scare people from doing this. It's just do it right.
Right.
And
exactly.
Don't fall into traps of scam artists and things like that.
Right.
And the Crooked Law Trust is doing it right, and they're able to get you funded out the gate, which is great.
And by the way, the Crooked Law Trust, the lawyer who is actually Cricken is
right.
Wade Cricken, and I want to say hello to Wade and the six beautiful children.
Okay.
Wade started in actually the Law Trust is a trust that now Adam here is working with Wade as an associate in Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And this kind of really ties its way into certain tax benefits. Why don't you tell me a little more about that?
I mean, there's all kinds of benefits to doing a trust. I mean, but I mean, this is a segue. This is different sort of than the ERC.
Yes.
Or the employee retention credit,
but
benefits of asset mm-hmm. protection, benefits of avoiding probate when you do a trust, benefits of all kinds of tax savings, and but it's going to depend person to person what they need, what they have going on in their lives, what kind of real estate they have, what kind of businesses they have, if they have businesses, or if they have savings and they want to shelter it there's all kinds of different scenarios that people have. And we would love to talk to everybody that needs a trust and help get them sorted out.
Well, we got 2 minutes left in the show. So give us the information they need to call if they're interested. And again, Robbie, hit the website again one more time so people know where they have to go.
So where you should go is www.my123erc.com. We have a lot of information on ERC. You put your information in, and an agent, one of us will contact you, actually. And or if you'd like to get in touch with us, you have Adam here.
You can also reach me locally here in Florida, 561-299-1413. If you have ERC questions or you just want to reach out by phone instead of doing the website, or if you have trust questions and want to start something, getting a trust set up. And I think Mike also segued, if you're facing some kind of financial hardship already, I also practice bankruptcy law.
Yes.
And I'd be happy to discuss that with whoever is in trouble and may need my help. It's a very, gratifying business where it's not something I do to get rich, but I do it to help people, and I love helping people.
Right. And if you have an IRS problem, of course, winningtaxsolutions.com, That's where you could find me, because now that the IRS announced its big new program, they're going after the waitresses and the waiters.
Right.
They're going after your tips,
right,
your tip money. And you're going to see a lot more IRS compliance issues, because they've already hired 5,000 new people, and they have another 80-something thousand coming over the next 10 years. And it's going to be a nightmare, I think, for the middle class. So they're going to need people like myself, like you, Adam, like Robbie. So I want to thank you guys for being on the show. That's all the time we have. And I want to thank you, the audience, for tuning in and watching our show tonight. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Have a great night. Till next time.
Yeah, thanks, Mike.
Okay.
Thank you for tuning in to Meet the Experts with Mike Vilardi. For more information, contact Mike at 888-994-4995, Studio A. Join us next time for another exciting show.